Good afternoon. It'll soon be Christmas, and we in the West go crazy at Christmas time, and everywhere's decked out. But also, when I lived in China for a while, I noticed that people gave Christmas cards there. There were Christmas trees everywhere, and the little dust carts went around going jingle bells, jingle bells. So, anyway, these are my thoughts on Christmas. Thoughts on the birth of Jesus. Where is the baby Jesus in all of the Christmas razzmatazz? Dear all, here are some thoughts I've had about Christmas. Strip away the tinsel, the Christmas tree, the gifts, the special street lights, stockings, Santa and Rudolph, Christmas plays, baking thousands of cookies for the students, rushing from party to party, shopping for gifts and special Christmas food. Christmas pudding, Christmas turkey, mulled wine, the candlelit services, Christmas day services, midnight mass, giving and receiving of cards. What is Christmas really about? Where is the baby Jesus in all of this? Is Christmas about letters to Santa and a visit to the North Pole to see him? Is it about good King Wenceslas or good Saint Nick who popped gold coins into poor girls' clogs so that they could find themselves a husband? Or is it about Befana, the kindly little white Italian witch who gives the gifts to good Italian children? Or is it St. Lucy with candles lighting up her blonde hair while serving cookies to her parents and siblings? That is the true meaning of Christmas. No sign of the baby Jesus here. But what about Babushka of Russian fame, who with her basket of toys wanders the world asking, "Is he here? Is the Christ child here?" And as she goes, she pops a toy into the tiny shoe in the hopes that perhaps it belongs to the baby king the wise men talked about when they visited her and rested in her house before following the star. They had invited her to go with them, but she declined, saying she had to clear up the mess, and besides, she could not leave just then. But she would follow them later, catch them up. Although she did leave, she never caught them up. And she did, but she did find the stable, but the baby Jesus was not there. Instead, the carnage of Herod's massacre of the innocents distressed her so much, she took to wandering the world in search of the infant king, but she did not find him. Where, oh, where is the baby Jesus born to be king? Can we find him in all of this razzmatazz about Christmas? Let's see if we can. The coming of a saviour, a king, was foretold in both the Hebrew scriptures and the ancient bone manuscripts of the Chinese held in Taiwan. There it is clearly set out that Adam and Eve were kicked out of the Garden of Eden by God for picking and eating the forbidden fruit, commonly thought to be an apple. Now, in China, the apple is a symbol of peace and is given to people on Christmas Eve as a peace gift. That is why the saviour has come, because Adam and Eve had destroyed the peace and harmony between God and man. The peace had been destroyed. The baby Jesus was descended from the royal line of David through both his mother and his earthly father. He was in line to be king, but the evil usurper Herod sat on the throne of David, the shepherd king. A shepherd king? Now that is a strange thought. Hold it in your head. Mary and Joseph had travelled by donkey and walked all the way from Nazareth in the north to Bethlehem in the south, she in the final month of pregnancy, an arduous journey and terrifying for a young girl no older than 16. The jolting of the donkey and the roughness of the road brought on the pains of labour. There was nowhere for them to stay except the dirty, stinking stable with perhaps a few chickens, sheep, a cow or two, and maybe a goat. It was full of animal manure, dirty smells, dirt and germ, but it was better than outside in the field where the night air was cold. Mary had no one to help her with the birth, only faithful Joseph. The birth being a first baby was probably quite long, painful and frightening for the young mother. Baby Jesus had to struggle to get into this world, just like every other baby born into this world, with the exception of those born by C-section. But not for him the sanitized hospital or the comfort of the birthing pool, but a stable, the humblest of places. For his cradle he did not have a smart perspex crib, but a manger full of hay. The world slumbered on, oblivious to the fact that the Saviour had been born. But out on the hills above Bethlehem, the shepherds, did I say shepherds? Yes, shepherds, the lowest of the low on the social scale. The humble shepherds were told by Gabriel and a host of angels singing peace on earth, goodwill to men, to go to Bethlehem and find the baby born to be king. They would find him in a stable. A king in a stable? They obeyed instantly, not like Babushka. They left their flocks of sheep. I like to think they left them with their faithful sheepdogs and went to Bethlehem, the birthplace of the first shepherd king, King David, and now the birthplace of the second shepherd king, King Jesus. And there they knelt in the stinking, dirty straw and worshipped at the rough wooden manger bed of the new shepherd king. Only this shepherd king would be the shepherd of his people down through the ages, who would be and are as equally silly as sheep. Here in the manger was the ultimate perfect lamb who was being prepared for the ultimate sacrifice of saving his people for eternity. The shepherds heard, the shepherds obeyed, they found the baby Jesus. A little later came the wise men from the east. Bear with me a little on this one. As my imagination, based on a recent reading, takes flight, tradition tells us they came from Persia, but I'd like to lay before you the idea that they came from China. These men knew that an important king was about to be born. All Chinese know that when an important emperor was about to be born in China, a special star appeared in the sky. Tradition tells them that this was so. Then these men studied manuscripts. The bone manuscript tells of a savior coming to restore man to God's favor. Put these two facts with the fact that all the gifts bought by the wise men all can be found in China, then link that with the Gobi Desert and the Silk Route and the legend of Babushka, because where she lived was on the Silk Route, and you have a possible revelation that the wise men from the East could have been Chinese scholars. They knew what they were looking for. Ancient documents had foretold. The star had announced. They obeyed. They came. They found the baby, and they worshipped him by kneeling down in the dirt in their silken robes and giving him gifts, acknowledge him as king. So East came to West and met in a humble place. The apple, a symbol of peace hoped for. The shepherd, symbolizing his caring ministry. The stable, humbleness. The wise men, a wise ruler, as wise as Solomon. The gifts, symbols of royalty, priesthood, and sacrifice. There in the humble stable, those who obeyed. Humble shepherds and rich wise men knelt, acknowledged and honoured the monarch, not of Israel, but of the galaxies. There in the symbolism of themselves and their gifts was embodied in the tiny body of the newborn king. Have you searched and found the baby Jesus in Christmas, like the wise men and the shepherds, or like Babushka? Are you still searching, searching everywhere, but can't find him? Remember, it's his birthday very soon. Blessings and love to you all at this season of the year. Carol. P.S. Grace, my teaching partner, had a baby boy today. She and Oliver have called him Peace. Well, however you celebrate Christmas, whether you just celebrate it as an excuse to eat, drink and be merry, or whether you celebrate the baby at the heart of Christmas, I just wish you all peace and blessings for the new year. Bye.